we've shown that we could demonstrate a 30% improvement in the patients who had received three administrations of CAN-2409, our investigational medicine, compared to placebo on top of standard of care radiotherapy.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Paul Peter Tack. He is the CEO of Candel Therapeutics. And Paul Peter, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm very well. Glad to be here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, good to have you along. Excited about some news that you had out recently that we want to talk about. This was the positive phase 3 clinical data for CAN-2409, and you presented this at the American Society of Radiation Oncology conference. And so let's take a step back and remind everyone about CAN-2409.
Yeah, CAN-2409 is a completely new approach to immunize the patient against the patient's own tumor. So basically, we teach the patient's own immune system how to recognize and eliminate the tumor cells throughout the body. And we've tested this in multiple indications, and the presentation at ASTRO, which was an oral presentation, which is an honor, was focused on the recently conducted clinical trial in early localized prostate cancer.
Yeah, so talk to me a bit about what you saw there in this data that you shared.
Yeah, so we are focused on patients who want to get rid of that tumor, basically, right? Who want to see that tumor eradicated. And these patients that we focus on elect to undergo radiotherapy of the prostate with curative intent. So the goal is to avoid recurrence of the disease and to avoid future problems like local progression and metastases, and ultimately, after prolonged follow-up, prostate cancer-related mortality, death. And what we've shown here, focusing on the primary endpoint that we agreed with the FDA under a so-called SPA, special protocol assessment, was disease-free survival. That means the absence of any evidence of remaining or recurring tumor cells. And we've shown that we could demonstrate a 30% improvement in the patients who had received three administrations of CAN-2409, our investigational medicine, compared to placebo on top of standard of care radiotherapy.
Yeah. You also in the release talked about the subgroup analysis and the key to that, because that's a really important part of this.
It really is. So what I just mentioned is the primary endpoint, but this was supported by multiple secondary endpoints. So it's a very consistent data package. It could demonstrate the benefit looking at the microscopic level, even in the biopsies from the prostate after 2 years. But then we also asked the question, does it matter whether patients got standard of care short-term hormonal therapy, which is androgen deprivation therapy, that's basically chemical castration. It was used in the trial, and we left that to the discretion of the treating physician in about half of the patients. And previously, we have demonstrated that the benefit of CAN-2409 compared to placebo was independent of the use of short-term ADT, gives us a lot of flexibility. The news that we presented at ASTRO is that patients may also use different regimens of radiotherapy. So there's the conventional radiotherapy, and more lately, there's a new form of radiotherapy where you basically give the same dose, overall total dose, but in fewer sessions, which is patient-friendly. So that's called hypofractionated radiotherapy. You give a higher dose per session. And here we could show that the benefit of CAN-2409 versus placebo was independent of the specific type of radiotherapy, whether it was conventional radiotherapy or hypofractionated radiotherapy. Again, that supports the flexibility in clinical practice.
So obviously, encouraged by the data that you saw, so what's the next step now? Where do you go?
Yeah, the major next step is to continue to work on commercial manufacturing. That's just a lot of work, and we are halfway since we had the data readout, and we make very good progress there. But it basically means you scale up manufacturing, and then you need to put it up on stability. You need to show to the FDA that the new product is stable, and you need to show in the lab that it is comparable to the previous product that was used in the clinical trial. That's not a clinical experiment. You need to show that in the lab in terms of purity and the specific characteristics. So that just takes time, but we are making very good progress there. So we expect to submit BLA, so seek approval of the medicine in Q4 next year. So basically 1 year from now. We just ended Q4 of 2025. And meanwhile, we'll continue to work with the FDA. We got an RMAT designation with the data in hand. RMAT means Regenerative Medicine Advanced Therapy designation. That's basically a breakthrough designation for a gene therapy like CAN-2409. So that's great. It gives us the opportunity to have frequent contact with the FDA to discuss what is it exactly that they want to see before we even submit the BLA. So we will probably do additional work in patients in a short-term small study, where we look at biodistribution of the new product and shedding. So this is a viral immunotherapy, so you want to show what happens over time and whether it's comparable to the previous product. And that's standard practice in manufacturing.
Makes a lot of sense. Dr. Tack, thank you so much. Good update, and I really appreciate your time, and we'll talk again soon, okay?
It was a pleasure. Thank you so much.
All right, there is Dr. Paul Peter Tack. He is the CEO of Candel Therapeutics.